So for the peptide map analysis, I've made a sequence variant workflow in Unify, which allows us to look at the data from both the trastuzumab and the biosimilar digests. It allows us to look at a reference comparison, again, between the two digests to identify which peptides are the same between the two molecules and which have differences. And then we have a sequence variant step, which will allow us to elucidate the differences between the two molecules. And then the final step will just focus on the newly assigned peptides. So I performed a triptych digest on both the trastuzumab and the biosimilar molecule. And I also spiked the biosimilar into trastuzumab at different concentrations. So we have starting from 1% of the biosimilar through to a 50-50 mix of the two molecules. And this was done just to see at what level we could go down to of the biosimilar. Because in the real world, a sequence variant could be there at a much lower percentage of the actual non-sequence variant. Okay, so in the first workflow step, we're just reviewing the results. So we can see here this table, the component table, is ordered by fragment ions. So the peptides that have the most BNY ions associated with them are ranked highest. So we can see here we also have the coverage map and a list of the peptides that have been identified. You have a modifier column and we have a percentage modification. So in the second workflow step, I've applied a filter to show coverage when at least two fragment ions are present. So this just adds confidence to the peptides that we're seeing coverage of. So at the moment we're still looking at the trastuzumab molecule. If I switch to the biosimilar, we can see now that there are a couple of regions in this molecule that have gaps in. So it might be interesting to see if these are the regions that have the different sequences or sequence variants. So in the reference comparison, we're now going to look at the chromatograms, the BPI chromatograms, between the biosimilar and the innovator. Okay, so I'm going to start by zooming in on a specific region of the chromatogram. And the biosimilar is a reference, so I now need to choose the innovator trastuzumab to do the comparison. So we can see there's a peak at 9.54 minutes that's present in the biosimilar but not in the innovator. And there's also a peak at 4.56 minutes that's present in the biosimilar and not the innovator. So these could be two candidate peptides that we can take through for elucidation. So in the next workflow step, the sequence variant step, we're going to target these two peptides in the biosimilar and see if we can use the tools in Unify to elucidate what the sequence is. So I'm going to choose the biosimilar now, because that's the one that we need to focus on. And now I need to select those two peptides in the chromatogram. Okay, so if you look at the peak at 9.54 minutes, and highlight that. So we can see this has a candidate mass. So in Unify, if a component isn't identified, it's given the name candidate. And we can see here that we can use the summary plot to track the response of this candidate peptide throughout the batch of samples. So if you remember, I've spiked in the biosimilar to the trastuzumab at different levels. And you can see that this peptide follows that trend quite nicely. So it's not present at all in trastuzumab, which is what we'd expect. It's there in the biosimilar, and it goes down corresponding to the percentage that I spiked in. So that's encouraging. That kind of gives me the confidence this is actually a real peptide that's unique to the biosimilar. So if I right click on this candidate mass and say elucidate, it will now take me through to a suite of tools that can be used to actually see what the amino acid sequence is. So we're going to use a sequence variant search. Okay, so basically this is going to take the in silico list of digested peptides from the trastuzumab sequence, the innovator sequence, and it's going to see if it can change one or two amino acids in each peptide sequence and match it to both the precursor and the B and Y ions for this candidate. Okay, so I'm going to change this number here, okay, which is what's used to find the sequence variants. It's based on the BLOSSOM matrix. Okay, and I'm just going to start that off. So the software's doing quite a lot now. It's taking that big list of in silico triptych peptides, and again, it's creating different amino acid substitutions in each peptide to see if it can match. And this substitution likelihood is based on, again, this matrix. It's going to look for the most probable amino acid substitutions. Okay, so it's come up with a possibility here. So if I click on this, you can see that on triptych peptide 8 of the light chain, which is what the one means here, we have a valine to isoleucine substitution. Okay, and we have some B and Y ions there, okay, to give this confidence. So if I'm happy with that, I'm going to assign it. And then I'm going to go back to the sequence variant step, and we're going to look at the other peptide that you wanted to target, which was at 4.56 in the chromatogram. Okay, so this time we have a candidate mass of 605.31, and we can see we're observing the same pattern in the summary plot, where the response to this peptide is decreasing with the decreasing amounts of the biosimilar actually in there. Okay, so again, it's a good candidate. So I'm going to do exactly the same thing now. I'm going to click elucidate, and I'm going to run the sequence variant search. So again, the same process is going on here with the list of in silico triptych peptides and the amino acid substitutions. Okay, so this time on triptych peptide 35 on the heavy chain, which what the two means there, there's actually two amino acid substitutions. There's an E to a D and an M to an L. And again, we have the B and Y ions to confirm that. So again, I'm going to assign that. And now we can go to the final workflow step, which is newly assigned peptides. Okay, and now we've put a filter on just to show the peptides that have been identified by the sequence variant search. Okay. So if you look at the coverage map, we can now see that we have a sequence variant on the light chain and a sequence variant on that region of the heavy chain that we saw in the subunit analysis. So that's quite nice. And these are the actual three amino acids. So we have two amino acids on the heavy chain, and there's one triptych peptide, and we have one in the light chain. And the whole molecule just has these three differences in amino acids. So that was the peptide map analysis. In the next part, we're going to look at release glycan analysis.